in addition to recombination, mutation is another phenomenon which causes genetic variations. And mutations are the phenomena which cause alteration of the DNA sequences and thereby resulting in changes in the genotype as well as phenotype of an organism. Mutation is a permanent change in the DNA molecule of an organism. Mutations occur randomly, may be spontaneous or it may be induced. Mutations are heritable changes. There are two types of mutations, the gene mutations and the chromosomal mutations or chromosomal aberrations. The gene mutations are called as point mutations, which are the changes that occur in an individual gene. These are due to the structural change in the DNA molecule at a single point. And this change, structural change in the DNA molecule at any part may alter the message conveyed by that gene. So the gene mutation changes the nucleotide sequence of the DNA molecule at that particular locus. Thereby, the whole message which is given on the messenger RNA will be changed, resulting in the formation of a defective amino acid and thereby defective protein. And point mutations could be dominant, recessive. Some of them are lethal, some of them are harmless. These point mutations may be linked to the X chromosomes or linked to the autosomes also. Now the chromosomal aberrations or chromosomal mutations are the changes in the number or the structure of chromosomes. And the chromosomal aberrations due to structural changes may occur during the first prophase of the first meiosis, that is during the homologous chromosomes pairing and their crossing over. So the sequence of genes may alter and genes in the new locations may cause certain alterations of the expressions. And these kind of changes may be due to the deletion of a segment of the DNA, similarly insertion of segments, doubling of the same segment, duplication. Sometimes the sequence can be inverted, altered sequence can be also. Then some chromosomal segments can be translocated. The place of it, the sequence of it can be changed. Then there are chromosomal aberrations due to change in number. Mutations caused by the addition of one chromosome, which is called aneuploidy, or maybe due to the addition of more sets of chromosomes. We have normally the diploid 2n. Sometimes we will find more n's, 3n, 4n type, which is called polyploidy. Down syndrome, Klinefelter syndrome, Turner syndrome are some of the human disorders due to the chromosomal aberrations. Then mutations also arise due to changes in the single base pair of DNA, which is called as the point mutation. Example is the sickle cell anemia. Then deletions and insertions of base pairs of DNA causes frame shift mutations. And the mechanism of mutation, maybe the mutations may be spontaneous and induced mutations. Depending on the cause of mutation, they can be spontaneous if they occur naturally in nature, or as induced, if they are deliberately induced by certain agents, like chemical mutagens are there, variety of chemicals like ethyl methane sulfonate, mustard gas, all these are chemical mutagens. Then there are the physical mutagens or physical factors like the X-rays, gamma rays, ultraviolet rays, and such kind of cosmic radiations. It is not possible to perform genetic experiments in human beings in the way they were done in the peas or any other organisms. But at the same time, human heredity is very important from the biological, medical points of view. Humans have a long generation time and often produce a much smaller number. So in such cases, to study the inheritance of a trait, the pedigree analysis is done, where the information about the family is collected and assembled like a family tree. So pedigree analysis is a system of analysis where the traits in of the family for several generations are collected and arranged and analyzed. So in the pedigree analysis, the inheritance of a particular trait is represented by the family tree over generations. Now, pedigree analysis helps in many ways, like it helps to predict the possible genotypes by knowing the phenotypes. It helps to study the pattern of inheritance of a specific trait, abnormality or disease. Then possible genetic makeup of a person for a trait can be found out. So genetic counselors can advise the parents or the couples about the possibility of having genetically defective children. So such kind of uses are there of this pedigree analysis. Then the genetic disorders. May be grouped into two categories, the Mendelian disorders and the chromosomal disorders. Mendelian disorders are mainly determined by the alteration or mutations in the single gene, and these are transmitted to the offspring on the same lines as we have studied of the principles of inheritance, Mendelian factors. And the pattern of inheritance of Mendelian factors can be traced in the family by the pedigree analysis. Examples are hemophilia, cystic fibrosis, sickle cell anemia, color blindness, phenylketonuria. All these are examples. And Mendelian disorders may be dominant or recessive, but by pedigree analysis one can easily understand whether the trait is a dominant one or a recessive one. Hemophilia is a sex-linked recessive disease which is caused by a recessive allele which is present on the X chromosome. And in a hemophiliac, the blood takes very long time to clot, and so the individual bleeds profusely even from a minor cut. And a single protein, which is part of the group of proteins involved in the clotting of blood, is affected. So in an affected individual, a simple cut will result in non-stop bleeding. And the heterozygous female is a carrier for hemophilia. She may transmit the disease to her sons. And the female becoming a hemophilia is extremely rare case, because mother of such a female has to be a carrier and the father should be a hemophiliac, so that the female will become a hemophiliac. And the family history pedigree analysis, you can find out the inheritance of such a disease occurring in the family or not. And a hemophilic person needs a transfusion of blood or the transfer of the clotting factor, factor 8, which is associated with the clotting, and that factor is absent. So that factor in a concentrated form is given to the normal blood frequently, so that we can be somewhat getting kind of betterment from the disease. And hemophilia tends to run in the families and appear in the males. It has been studied in great detail in the family of Queen Victoria and her descendants, where a number of males died of hemophilia as mothers were the carriers. Now the next disease is sickle cell anemia. This is an autosome linked recessive trait which are transmitted from parents to the offsprings when both the partners are carriers for the gene and both of them are heterozygous. And the disease is controlled by a single pair of allele, HB. HBA and HBS, that is a heterozygous condition. Now, out of the three possible genotypes, only the homozygous individuals with HBS and HBS only show the deceased phenotype. And the heterozygous HBA and HBS individuals appear unaffected, but they are the carriers of the disease. So 50% probability of transmission of the gene to the progeny, thereby the sickle cell trait exhibiting this kind of an inheritance. And in this sickle cell, the defect is caused by the substitution of glutamic acid by valine at the sixth position on the beta globin chain of the hemoglobin molecule. And this substitution in the globin protein is happening due to the single base substitution at the sixth codon of the beta globin gene from GAG to GUG. GAG is shifted, changed to GUG. So the mutant hemoglobin molecule undergo polymerization under low oxygen pressure, causing the change in the shape of the red blood cells from the biconcave disc to the sickle-shaped blood cells, which is having low oxygen carrying capacity. Then the third error is the phenylketonuria. The inborn error of metabolism inherited by autosomal recessive trait, and the affected individual lacks the enzyme which convert amino acid phenylalanine to tyrosine. So the phenylalanine is accumulated and it gets converted into phenylpyruvic acid and some other derivatives, and the accumulation of these in the brain results in mental retardation and some amount of it is excreted in the urine, but still this phenyl pyruvic acid gets accumulated in the blood and it damages the brain. Chromosomal disorders may be due to the changes in the number of either autosomes or the sex chromosomes, or from alteration in the chromosome structure, or by addition or loss of one set, aneuploidy, or addition of more sets, that is polyploidy of chromosomes. Now, aneuploidy occurs due to the failure of segregation of chromatids during cell division and results in the gain or loss of a chromosome in the gametes formed. And this will give rise to abnormal number of chromosomes in the zygote. Examples are Down syndrome, Turner syndrome, Klinefelter syndrome. So in Down syndrome, or Down syndrome is due to the gain of extra copy of chromosome number 21, the autosome. Then Turner syndrome is due to the loss of an X chromosome in human female. So that condition is called X0 condition. Normal female is X and X, but here this female will have X and 0 condition. Klinefelter syndrome is due to an additional copy of the X chromosome. So X, X and Y condition. Then there is the failure of cytokinesis after telophase stage of the cell division results in the increase in the whole set of chromosomes in an organism. So this phenomenon is called polyploidy, is due to an increase in the entire haploid sets of chromosomes. When there are three haploid sets of chromosomes or 3N condition, it is called triploid. That way diploid condition is the normal one, so 2N number. When there are three sets of haploid chromosomes, the 3N condition, which is the triploid condition. When 4 sets or 4N condition is there, tetraploid. Polyploidy is rare in animals, but which is common in plants. And polyploidy is associated with increased size and greater hardness and increased resistance to diseases. Now we'll see about the Down syndrome, which is due to the presence of an extra chromosome number 21. So trisomy of 21st chromosome is causing the Down syndrome or mongolism. And these individuals will have 47 chromosome, not the 46 in their body cells. And Down syndrome is due to the unequal distribution of chromosomes during the egg cell formation. So non-disjunction of the chromosomes during the meiosis in the egg formation. Now the incidence of Down syndrome increases with the age of the mother. Then symptoms are there. Severe physical, psychomotor and mental retardation is seen, and individual is very short statured individual. There are various abnormalities in the face itself, flattened nose bridge, habitually open mouth, prominent forehead, broad flat face, lower lips are protruding, big and wrinkled protruding tongue, and a characteristic fold of skin at the corner of the eyes, the short and broad neck, then many loops on the fingertips, malformation of heart, there is a higher incidence of congenital heart defects and underdeveloped gonads. Then the second disease is Klinefelter's syndrome. This is caused due to the presence of an additional copy of the X chromosome. Klinefelter's syndrome. So karyotype, the chromosome number will be 47, but XX and Y chromosome. So the individual is a male and has an overall masculine development, underdeveloped testes, little hair on the body, person will be mentally retarded. The feminine development, like development of breasts, is seen. Individuals are sterile due to abnormal seminiferous tubules. Then there is Turner's syndrome, which is caused by the absence of the X chromosome. So the individual has got only 45 chromosomes and the X0 sex chromosomes. Individual is a female but is sterile. Underdeveloped ovaries, underdeveloped breasts, short stature and characteristic webbed neck. Often sterile as they may not menstruate or ovulate. These are the symptoms. So secondary sexual characters will be absent in the persons or individuals with Turner's syndrome, and they are subnormal in their intelligence.